Okay, guys, now let's talk about the disadvantages. So number one is the slow ROI, return on investment. It does take 5 days after the item gets delivered to get your payout processed. That is if you provided a valid tracking such as USPS or FedEx or UPS, or then you will have to wait 14 to 21 plus days in instances where your tracking number is not validated, such as TBA, USPS fake tracking numbers, and anything else that is not accepted by Facebook. That is actually something that I'm trying to also balance out myself to this day and find the golden balance, because, for example, you can scale your efforts and have 110 plus and more orders per day with no issues using my strategy, but you have to remember that at first you will have to invest quite a good amount of money to pay for all those 100 plus orders upfront, right? And you will only get it back in 2 to 3 plus weeks. So you have to be realistic about this, and your bank account can look pretty scary for a period of time when you scale things up, but you just have to be mentally prepared, for your bank account to be lower before it becomes higher. So yeah, what that means is you also have to start slow, acquire savings, open some new credit cards, credit lines, possibly maybe take a business loan if you have an opportunity to do so. And then you definitely need to track how much money you're spending daily for cost of goods sold, as well as you need to track revenue and profit to ensure that you know what you're doing, that you're profitable in the end of the day. So yeah, and additionally, you can also use cashback business credit cards and other rewards, but we can talk more on that later in this course, so stay tuned there. Number two is glitches, of course. As being a seasoned seller with over a year of selling on marketplace with shipping, I can tell you that this platform is definitely evolving and changing really, really quickly. This also means that there will be glitches along the way, because Facebook is just way, way too big to do a proper QA of everything. There are 2 billion people, you know, it's really complicated to QA everything, and glitches that you will likely experience and that other people reported experiencing include the slow social security verification once you hit $600 in sales, account bans, account lockouts, shadow bans. It's not guaranteed that you will experience these glitches, but it might happen. But marketplace has seen improvements over the last year. The customer service is better now than it was before. So, you know, there is ups and downs, and you just need to be ready that bugs can happen. But, you know, you can submit bugs to the customer service representative and they usually will be able to help. But on this topic, you know, number three is seller support. It used to be way worse last year. I honestly think it has improved this year. Considering that you can also use a special link, which I included in the notes section. This link is actually for dedicated support, meaning that you will have a dedicated representative on any issue that you report, whether it's a disapproved listing or it is a glitch. Just again, be prepared that it takes them about 24 to 48 hours to respond. So if, for example, you have an account ban, you know, there is a chance that you might lose some revenue, because if you don't provide a tracking number within 3 business days, Facebook might start canceling those orders. So, you know, just have to keep that in mind. But if you use this link for dedicated support, you should be fine. This is an exclusive link that is available for the marketplace sellers group. So I have also linked that one, so be sure to join that group, and then you will likely have access to this link that I shared. Then, you know, number four, shipping is available only to the continental US residents, meaning that if you are in Hawaii or Alaska, most likely your shipping option will not be there. You just have access to local pickups. And same about, you know, if you're going to go abroad, most likely you are going to lose the shipping option, like I did when I went to visit my family in Russia shortly after I quit my job. Actually, the rules used to be different, but in February they rewrote one of the rules that if you're traveling abroad, then you will essentially lose access to shipping, but it will be restored once you are back in the United States. And I have included this bullet so you can read the policy, basically. But yes, that is a disadvantage if you are watching this and if you are abroad. Most likely, this will be a struggle. You can try to use a VPN, but I did not have a good experience with it. Actually, my account got disabled because of a VPN, and it took me like a month and a half to get it back. But you know, you can risk it. If you do use a VPN, make sure to use a static VPN, because if you have, you know, a free VPN that constantly changes your IP address, it will freak Facebook out and you will likely risk getting your account disabled. So keep that in mind. Number five is manual work. You know, at first, when you're first starting out, and at first when you're scaling, it will be a little bit manual. Unless you have a VA team like I currently do, you will be jack of all trades for a little bit, but again, it will be 100% worth the effort. Once you scale, once you get enough orders to cover for VAs, absolutely hire a VA, because you will get burnt out fulfilling all those orders, doing customer service. It started happening to me, but then I outsourced all the work. Not only did it give me more free time, but it also actually resulted in our business making more money, because now I have more time focusing on business strategy and just enjoying more time with my family and doing things I love, you know? So absolutely. But also you can use a software like FBM Fox or ZDrop. Again, I'm not a huge fan of using those, because I'm not sure if these guys, if you're just giving away your data to them, but you know, you can still try and use them when you're first starting out and you really don't have time. But to be honest, you should be able to find just an hour or two to fulfill a few orders and then scale things up. And then once you scale, hire a VA. But you know, just take it easy and be mindful of that. And lastly, 3 business days to provide a tracking number. This is your hard set deadline. And it's a pretty straightforward deadline, because you know, you need to ship orders within 3 business days. If you don't, Facebook will basically cancel it. But the good news is, if you're sourcing from eBay, Amazon, Walmart, and any other American supplier, most of these people tend to provide the tracking number within 24 to 48 hours after purchase. And we have only few cases where we need to, you know, ship an order later than promised. But if you do ship order later than promised, you also get dinged on your seller metrics. But more on that later. So keep this deadline in mind. Okay, well, this is it for the disadvantages. I hope this clarifies it a little bit. But if you have any other questions, let me know and I will be happy to answer.